In this video, we'll walk you through how to configure real-time monitoring and control across your cloud apps, leveraging Microsoft Cloud Apps Security's native and powerful integration with Azure Active Directory. Consider risky situations in the modern workplace, like users accessing corporate resources from unmanaged devices or external users accessing your environment. In these scenarios, users still need access to corporate resources, but you want to limit actions such as download, upload, and copy and paste. This feature uses a reverse proxy architecture. As a prerequisite, the web applications you apply these controls to must be configured with single sign-on in Azure AD and use the SAML or OpenID Connect authentication standards. To configure this feature, start in the Azure portal and navigate to Azure Active Directory. Then, click on Conditional Access. To create a new policy, click on New Policy. First, give your policy a name. Then, select the users or groups that you want to include or exclude from this policy and click Done. Now select the relevant cloud apps you want to control with this policy. In this case, I'm going to select Salesforce. And then I'll click Done. Under Conditions, you can specify when the policy will apply. For this example, we will configure this policy to exclude managed devices. Click on Device State and then select Yes under Configure. Next, click on Exclude. Then select Device Marked as Compliant and Device Hybrid Azure AD Joined. Now click Done. Lastly, under Session, select Use Conditional Access App Control. Common controls include blocking download and monitoring activities for auditing purposes, and they can be applied directly from within Azure AD. In this case, we'll select Block Download. Now click Done, and then click Create to finalize the policy. By the way, more granular policies and advanced settings and controls can be configured in the Microsoft Cloud Apps Security portal, such as evaluating device management via certificate trust chains and blocking copy, cut, paste, and other activities. Now let's take a very brief look at the end user experience that this policy generates for a user in Salesforce. When the user attempts to download a sensitive document, the download will be blocked in real time, and the user will be informed as to why. Many combinations of these granular activities, conditions, and actions can be created with this feature, and we will walk you through some of our most popular use cases in subsequent videos.